What's up, guys? My name is Amir. Welcome back to the channel, and I am really excited for today's video because we have the PlayStation 5 here in the studio. In this video, I'm going to take you through its features, how it's different from the PS4, its capabilities and limitations, and we're also going to show you some gameplay footage because I have Spider-Man Miles Morales in the house. So the PS5 comes in two variants. One is the standard edition, which has the Blu-ray disc drive in it. This one's for $4.99, and then there's also a digital edition, which is a download-only variant. It doesn't have a Blu-ray disc drive, and that one's $100 cheaper. So let's go ahead and check out the PS5. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell so that you don't miss out on future videos. So as soon as you switch the PS5 on, you'll feel this freshness. There's now a new animation, which is of course in 4K, and these dust particles and light rays look absolutely gorgeous. Welcome to the new era of console gaming. Now with the new PS5, Sony has gone for an entirely new design language. Where previously the PS4 had a very boxy sort of design, this time the PS5 has curves and edges and it looks really futuristic. PS5 is also bigger in size and has more weight to it. And then last time the whole console was in one color, whereas this time we have a two-tone black and white color scheme, where this black bit in the center has a glossy finish, while the white sides have a soft touch matte finish. On this black center area, you have a status LED, and behind it, there are the air cooling vents. Now, you can keep this console stood up vertically or lie down horizontally with the stand included in the box. Talking about button placement and ports, on the front of the console, we have a power button and a disc eject button. Alongside this, we also have a Blu-ray disc slot and a USB Type-C and USB-A port to charge your controllers with and connect external storage drives. On the back of the console, we have a power port, an HDMI port, an Ethernet port for your LAN cable, and two USB-A ports. So that was the design, button placement, and ports. Let's now talk about this DualSense controller. Here too, some major changes and upgrades have been made. For starters, the size. Compared with PS4's DualShock controller, you can see that this DualSense controller is a bit bigger and also follows the new design language. Now, it is up to your own personal preference whether you like this new PS5 design language or not. But for me, after spending time with the PS5, the previous generation feels quite dated. And the difference here is not just in looks. There are some major tech upgrades within this DualSense controller. And specifically, there are two major upgrades. Better haptic feedback and adaptive triggers. Where previously the DualShock controller was able to put out only basic vibrations, here we have a new haptic motor which can deliver a bunch of different types of vibrations and clicks to better simulate the environment of your gameplay. The haptic feedback of driving a car will be very different from punching someone or shooting a gun or a bus driving past you. It's really fantastic and gives you a new level of immersion. And the adaptive triggers are called adaptive because they change or adapt their resistance according to the game you're playing and the situation that you're in. So in game, when you're pressing a trigger, you'll feel an activation point. When you're pulling something, you'll feel the resistance of the trigger changing as it gets tougher and tougher to pull. This again leads to better levels of immersion and more satisfying gameplay. There's an awesome demo of this controller in the free PS5 game Astro's Playroom. When I pull this trigger, I can physically feel an activation point. Very satisfying. Then this controller also has a touchpad, motion sense, a headphone jack, and this time there's also an inbuilt mic as well as a mute switch to toggle your mic or gameplay sounds on or off. And of course on the back we have a USB port, which has been updated to Type-C this time around. Now moving on to the specifications of the console, one of the big game changers here is the new storage drive, which is an 825 gig solid state NVMe drive. And this does wonders to bringing the load times down. Where in the PS4, you were probably used to seeing long loading screens. With the PS5, load times aren't non-existent, but as you can see here, they are substantially shorter. We also have a new CPU, GPU, and more RAM. Here we have an AMD Ryzen-based octa-core CPU and RDNA 2 GPU, pumping out 10.28 teraflops compared to only 1.84 teraflops in the PS4. And up from 8 gigs last time, we now have 16 gigs of GDDR6 RAM, giving the PS5 memory bandwidth of 448 gigabytes per second. So what do these specs mean for your gameplay? Well, for starters, we have standard 4K 60 frames per second gameplay. Then we also have 4K at 120 frames per second. And the PS5 can also support a maximum of 8K resolution as advertised on the box. But it's not just about resolution and frame rates here. With this new hardware, the PS5 now supports ray tracing and can produce more complex textures and shapes. With ray tracing, you get more realistic reflections, bounce light and shadows also feel more true to life. If you play Miles Morales on high fidelity settings where where you get high quality at a lower 30 frames per second, you'll feel that the game looks more realistic, detailed, and more true to life. Then you also have the option to play at high performance settings where the ray tracing and textures are toned down, but you get 4K at 60 frames per second. So even though the overall experience is far better than what we saw before, here and there you will see limitations, especially if you're a hardcore gamer. But at least on some level, you have to appreciate the fact that a $500 console supports 4K at 120fps or even 8K gaming. Of course, for 120fps, you're going to need a TV that supports 120Hz. Then you're also going to need a game that can be run on that high a frame rate. With 8K gaming, I imagine the limitations are going to be much more. But consider this. Even if it just supports 8K gaming, imagine how good it will be at 4K gaming. And it costs only $400 to $500, which is much less than what you'd have to pay for a fully kitted out gaming PC. By the way, the fan noise on the PS5 was not much at all. I remember with the PS4, once you had it fired up, it would make a lot of fan noise, but here the fan noise was barely noticeable. And since the PS5 is only just launched, its game library is a bit limited, but in time, you'll see this library grow. And of course, the PS5 is also backwards compatible, so you can play your favorite PS4 titles on it if you want to. So at a price point of $400 to $500, the PS5 offers you an excellent gaming experience. This really is the next step in console gaming and a welcome change after more than 7 years with the PS4. And I'm really excited to see how game developers leverage these new hardware capabilities and come up with more realistic and more immersive gameplay for us. So I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to drop a like on it, and also please support the channel by sharing this video with your friends. If you have any feedback regarding the PS5, do leave it in the comment section below. That'll be it for this one. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.